You don't look so bad, Becker. No, as a matter of fact, you look quite well. You don't seem to have changed at all. That's it. You haven't changed. Why, it's been 15 or 16 years.
It's been 17 years, Captain, since you and I last saw each other.
Really? You're the caretaker around here?
In a manner of speaking.
It's odd how paths cross and we meet again under somewhat happier circumstances. What was that? Sounded like
the wind, Captain.
Wind?
Perhaps. Perhaps it was the wind, eh?
Of course. Of course it was the wind. It was not the wind. It was.
It was what, Captain?
Stop calling me Captain. I'm not a soldier anymore.
You never were a soldier. The uniform you wore cannot be stripped off. It was part of you, part of your flesh, part of your body. It was a piece of your mind. A tattoo, Captain. A skull and crossbones burned into your soul.
I was a soldier, Becker.
No, Captain, you were a sadist. You were a monster who derived pleasure from giving pain.
Listen to me, Becker. There's no more war. That's all in the past. There are no more camps. It's ridiculous. It's utterly ridiculous to dwell on these things. You did as you thought best, and I functioned as I was told. What is this noise?
Strange that it should disturb you so. It never used to, Captain. When your victims screamed, you weren't so sensitive. But now, they are not screaming. No, they're reacting. They just heard you offer the apology for all the monsters of our times. We did as we were told. We functioned as ordered. We merely carried out directives from our superiors. Familiar, is it, Captain? It was the Nazi theme music at Nuremberg. The new lyrics to the Götterdämmerung. The plaintive litany of the master race as it lay dying. We did not do. Others did, or someone else did it. We never even knew that it was being done, or we did it. But others told us to. Captain Lutze, 10 million human beings were tortured to death in camps like this. Men, women, children, infants, tired old men. You burned them in furnaces. You shoveled them into the earth. You tore up their bodies in rage. And now you come back to your scenes of horror and you wonder that the misery that you planted has lived after you.
There's no point in talking about this any longer. I must leave you now, Becker.